So students, when you go to get a credit card, one of the things that is going to be featured on this really long text-rich document, I mean, it's like 1,000 words just popping out at you in really small font. You're like, what is happening here? One thing that's really important to analyze is the APR, annual percentage rate. That's the interest rate that a credit card company will charge you if you can't pay off your balance. Today, we're gonna look into an APR and then see what its finance charge is on some debt that you might have from a statement. So down here on the board, I have APR defined, annual percentage rate, which is kind of like a fancy way of saying how much annual interest you'll have to pay on the debt that you have. So let's look at our balance. All right, we have a previous balance of $150. But here, instead of illuminating what the finance charge is, we just have the APR, and the APR is 20%. That is pretty typical. You can have introductory periods where the APR is 0% for 6 months. La, spend as much as you want for 6 months, and we won't charge you any finance charges. But then at the end of that honeymoon period, it pops right back up to somewhere around 20%. Then we have new purchases. Let's imagine that we are really conscious of the fact that we have a previous balance and we decide to cool it on the credit card. Let me go ahead and erase these parentheses. These are positive amounts, sorry. Okay, and then payments. You're able to pay $100 of this off. And there was some fraudulent activity on your card, so they canceled it and sent you a new one, and then credited you the $10 that somebody stole your card and went to go buy some groceries with it. You dropped it in the aisle of the grocery store, someone took it up and then went and spent 10 bucks. You called them up and you said, hey, there was fraudulent activity. Can you please credit my account? And they said, sure, no problem. This is not a consistent issue with you, so we don't assume that you are the fraudster. And they mail you a new one. But I keep coming back to this finance charge. We need to add this in. How do you calculate it? What is it? Is it gigantic? Is it small? Well, let's do a little bit of math and see what we have here. So, finance charge, 20%. And this is 20% per year, annual, right? Per annum or per year, annual, 20% per year. This balance is always monthly. Right, so we're gonna need to compensate for that a little bit later. But let's just pretend like this is over the year. Like, let's just simplify for just a second. So 20% of 150 might be hard to do in your head. You might be like, ugh. Not sure about this. But 10% of 150 you could do immediately. Right? You just divide by 10. 10% is our friend. Because whenever you need to take 10% of something, you just divide by 10. If I divide 150 by 10, boom, I know it's 15. Well, I don't want 10%, I want double that. Double of 10% is 20%. So if I did 10% of 150 and I got 15, all I need to do is double it to get to 20%. So 15 doubled, or times 2, is 30. So I'm just gonna write this off to the side that my annual interest expense I just calculated would have been 30. But the issue is that this is monthly. I don't want the whole annual figure because this is just 1 month's worth of data. So what can I do to take something that's in a year and convert it into a month? If only I knew how many months there were in the year. You're probably yelling at the screen 12, but I just think it's more fun to go January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. 12! Okay, you were right. All right, you were yelling at the screen. It's 12, Rogers! Come on, let's go! All right, but it is 12, so we don't want all 12 months of that. We want 1/12 of that. So we just need to divide this 30 by 12. 12 can go into 32 times. 24. We have our decimal here. 30 minus 24 is 6, bring a 0 down. 12 goes into 60 five times, right? So 2.5. All right, so 12 goes into 30, 2.5. So each month, 1/12 of this finance charge is $2.50. Thus, that is our finance charge for this month, $2.50. Okay, super. So what's really nice is that we recognized that we had a previous balance which we didn't want because then we have a finance charge. So we said, all right, let's live below our means for a little bit, not go out to the restaurant, have cooking in nights, you know, avoid the expensive cuts of meat and perhaps just go veggie only for a month. So you don't have any new purchases on your credit card. You paid off everything you could, $100, and you actually had some fraudulent activity, so you're going to get $10 credited back. So let's see what this is all together to find our new balance. So $152.50 is these two together, and $110 is $110. Well, that was easier. All right, we subtract these. These are in parentheses, which mean they're negative, so we subtract them, and we get $42.50. Okay, so that is our new balance, $42.50. You can see how financially responsible we were by not having any new purchases, putting a big payment down that month in order to decrease the new balance to $42.50. Now, what's really interesting is that you're still going to owe a 20% APR on $42.50 the next month. So you're still going to have a finance charge, but it'll be less than $2.50. And perhaps you can cool it one more month, pay off all your debts, and then you can have a clean $0 balance on your credit card again, and then hopefully not go through the cycle of overspending and then having finance charges, because finance charges are no good. You're not actually getting anything out of this. Like, you're not earning $2.50 worth of goods and services. You're paying that credit card company $2.50 because they loaned you money that you didn't have. So make sure to pay off your balances as best you can, because APR, it'll get you. Have a great day.